So now, what is normal concrete and what is special concrete? We need to understand these two things first. Before going into the concrete, what are the ingredients in concrete? What are all the ingredients in concrete? Fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, cement, which is the binding material or the binding content, if we have water. So in addition to this, you can add admixtures, additives and other materials according to the requirement. So if a normal, if a concrete contains only these as ingredients, it will be called as a normal concrete. Okay, mainly these properties, these materials induce certain properties in the concrete which gives certain strength to the normal concrete. Similarly, special concrete is concrete which is prepared to meet special requirements. Can this normal concrete be used or applied? Can we apply or use this normal concrete in aggressive environmental conditions? What is aggressive environmental conditions? Weather change, temperature differences, certain chemical attacks. So all these kind of situations, in these situations, can we use normal concrete? No, because if it is prepared only for certain conditional environmental conditions where it will be applicable and will be durable only in certain places, right? Under normal environmental conditions. When it goes to aggressive environmental conditions, you see that normal concrete will fail or it will have less durability. So it will also go for deterioration or destruction of the entire building if we use normal concrete in the aggressive environmental conditions. So in order to use concrete in aggressive or worse environmental conditions, we have come up with the special concrete, which is again meets the special requirements of that particular condition. Okay, so what are those special requirements now? Technically, the concrete will be made. Certain technical requirements will be done. For that particular, the concrete will be made. And also the technology, special technology will be used to produce the concrete or place the concrete. Technically, it will be having different strengths, durability, and the money we will be planning. And technology wise, special techniques or technology will be used to manufacture the concrete or place the concrete in the aggressive environmental condition. So those type of concretes are called as special concrete. So now, what are all the applications of special concrete? Can you name few areas of application of special concrete? Certain areas. And then we can use these type of special concrete.
Hills, seashores.
Offshore. Offshore buildings. Offshore structures. Okay. Like ports, harbor. So all these are going to be on in water. So water, that is sea water, which contains lots of salt and other chemicals or things which is again harmful to concrete. So for this situation, you need special concrete. Anything else? Airports, right? Then industrial buildings. So these type of special requirements or special areas, we go for using the special concrete. So this is the basic introduction about normal and special. Let's switch ingredients for normal concrete are normal ingredients like cement, water, fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. Here you will have special ingredients. That means, like in case of fiber reinforced concrete, you will have fibers inside. In case of polymers, you will have polymers inside, resins inside. In case of lightweight concrete, you will have some air bubbles or some no fines concrete and all those things. We have special ingredients in case of special concrete. Second is, it involves no special techniques. So you can do it manually, people can do it manually, mix it, same proportions and you can place it. Here, it involves special techniques and technology. Polymer infused concrete, you will have to infuse the polymer into the concrete through radiations or thermal actions and all those things. So those kind of special techniques we have to use in case of special concrete. Similarly, fiber reinforced concrete, we want to infuse the fibers into the concrete, you need some special techniques where the fiber gets bonded with the concrete. So the special techniques are used in special concrete. Then they are used in normal conditions, normal environmental conditions. Okay, here this is used mostly in aggressive conditions. Okay, used mostly in aggressive conditions. What is the next point? It is carried down by conventional method. So, as I said, normal convention and placing. Here is the special techniques. Then the properties of concrete like density, strength, etc. are normal range. What is the normal density of it? The density of a normal concrete ranges from, the density of normal concrete is around 2400 kilogram per meter cube. Normal density of concrete is 2400 kilogram per meter cube. In this case, the density might vary. It might increase or it might decrease. Mostly it ranges from 300 kg per meter cube to 5000 kg per meter cube. Okay, so the density for normal concrete is around 2400 kg per meter cube, whereas in case of special concrete, the density may range as minimum also as high also, because high goes with high density concrete, low goes with no fines concrete or aerated concrete. So this is the variation. And the last important point is, it is very cheap or economical, and this is high cost is involved because we are using special ingredients, special techniques, and the application is also is very special with the technology. So that is why it is high cost. So these are the things said. Classification is the taxonomy related to concrete. How much branches are there in producing concrete? Types are, what are the different methods by which we can produce concrete? So first we will see classification of concrete. The first conventional method of classification of concrete is PCC. We all know this, which is called as plain cement concrete, which is normally used in many places, and this will be used in places where the concrete should not have in contact with the soil, because soil level the reinforcements illama irunda mattumna it will be very durable. So wherever we for floors la enna pandrom, floors usually enna pandrom PCC dam place. So this is the plain cement concrete which is usually used. Okay, second one, what is the second one? You have the lime concrete. Okay, we'll just list it down and then we will go in details of each. So PCC is plain cement concrete. Lime concrete is, instead of cement, cement ku badala we will be adding lime. Okay, so to certain proportions, there are proportion where the lime will be added for cement. Cement will be totally replaced by lime. Next, third one is, which is RCC, reinforced cement concrete, where we are going to have steel reinforcements in between the concrete layers. Okay, next one is
pre-stressed
Epina, before the concrete is being manufactured or into place, the concrete is pre-stressed in earlier stage itself. So, if you are going to cast this beam in pre-stressed form, you will have this tech of reinforcement. Either as is here, we will put the reinforcements, then we will pour the concrete and we will make it to cure. Okay, it will be hardened and curing process will go. Here, by manufacturing itself, the tendon steel reinforcements will be put inside and this will be given a tension. So these both sides of the tendons will be pulled, okay, so that another stress we will create and the concrete will get intact with the entire system and the tendons will be very tight and that system is called as pre-stressed cement concrete. So then this area will be cut down and this will be used as a beam or whatever it is. Okay? So this is pre-stressed cement part. This is called as tendons in solo. Jack Machi in pump with hydraulic jack, there will be pulling the tendons. Next one is
lightweight.
So lightweight concrete, Amina. Immediately what we should understand that aggregates are going to be less. Namadla, what is the higher proportion of aggregates? Sand, fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. So, we have to replace the aggregates with lightweight aggregates. So, normal aggregates, they will use shale, clay materials, all those things. Use panni, pannanga, that is called as lightweight concrete. Okay. So, next one is?
Cellular
or aerated concrete. Aerated concrete. So here again in this aerated concrete the coarse aggregate will be entirely removed and gas bubbles will be infused into the concrete. You would have seen it will be very light in weight and you will have gas bubbles in the concrete. So that is certain dimensions up to which the gas bubbles should have the diameter of the gas bubble. You will not even know if there are dimensions. You will see that in detail later. Yeah, so this is called as cellular or aerated concrete. Remove the coarse aggregate completely, then add infuse gas bubbles into it. Okay. Next one is
sawdust
concrete. So this is again similar to that of lightweight concrete. We are going to use sawdust into the concrete, okay, instead of the aggregate. Right? Next one is vacuum concrete. So vacuum concrete is the excess water or the moisture that is present in the concrete should be removed, which will enhance the durability of the concrete. So in that case, when we put a vacuum mat sheet and remove the water, excess water from the concrete through the special equipment that is called as vacuum concrete. Details, we see first plain cement concrete. As the name indicates, it is just going to have fine aggregate, coarse aggregate, water and the binding material which is the cement. So usually it will be applied in places where the structure has contact with the soil. Engala, we have the structure to get in contact with the soil so that the reinforcements are not touching the soil in red. We use this plain cement concrete. Okay? So because soil or moisture reinforcement layer, it will be a problem, it will cause corrosion and finally the concrete structure is going to have less durability. So in places where the soil moisture, soil direct contact with the soil, the structure should have, we are going to use this plain cement concrete, mostly for floors in the ground floor and all those things. We are going to use this plain cement concrete. This is a normal concrete which is used in normal conditions. Okay, so that is plain cement concrete. Next is lime concrete. So as we said, lime concrete, cement is being replaced by lime. Okay, so here you can use lime plus fine aggregate, lime plus 4 cycles. So this concrete will be in this proportion. 9 plus 5 aggregate or 9 plus 4 aggregate. And if it is 9 plus 5 aggregate, the ratio will be 1 is to? The ratio should be 1 is to 2. If the lime concrete should have only 5 aggregate and lime, the ratio should be 1 is to 2. Okay? 1 proportion of lime and 2 proportion of 5 aggregate. If in case the lime plus 4 aggregate is being designed, it will be 1 is to 2. Okay? Mostly this will be used in monuments and other heritage buildings. Okay? So that is lime concrete. Reinforced cement concrete. So as the name itself indicates, we are going to have steel reinforcements into the concrete. Why are we having the reinforcements in concrete? To increase the tensile strength. We all know that concrete is good in compression, but it is weak in tension. To enhance the tension properties or to enhance the tensile strength, we are providing reinforcements in the form of steel into the concrete, which improves the tensile strength of the concrete. So this is mostly used in beams, columns, roofs, slabs and all those kind of structural elements. So this is called as reinforced cement concrete. So you would have seen, if a column is being laid, the reinforcements will be held in position, stirrups will be added and the concrete will be ordered and compact. So such type of concrete is called as reinforced cement concrete, which enhances the tensile strength of the concrete. Okay. Next one is pre-stressed cement concrete. So as I said, internal stresses. This, imagine this to be a concrete element, a beam. So the steel will be laid inside. The concrete will be poured in the mold. Okay, inside this the steels will be, the tendons will be held tightly. Concrete will be poured and internal stresses will be developed. Internal stresses will be developed by giving a pull from both sides. So when these tendons are pulled on both sides against, a tension is being developed that induces internal stresses and increases the entire element's strength. So then once it is until the concrete is getting hardened, the stresses will be there. Once it is harden, the stresses in the pull tension are little longer, then it will have the element strength in that particular element. So this is called as pre-stressed cement concrete, where we can take lots of high loads, this kind of concrete is being used. Okay. So the internal stresses will be developed by external pressure, pull tension. The internal stresses will be developed by external tension, which is being applied to the steel reinforcements inside, tendons, and then the concrete is being manufactured. So this is mostly manufactured at the company. So next we have the lightweight concrete. Here the heavy material in concrete is aggregates. So those aggregates are replaced by lightweight aggregates. Okay. So normal gravel, which we use as aggregate, coarse aggregate, is heavy, which gives the density of 2400 kilogram per meter cube. And the weight and the high density, what is the reason? The normal coarse aggregates, which gives high density to the concrete. If we replace the coarse aggregate by lightweight aggregates called as clay, shale, slate. So these are all other, again gravel kind of thing, but having less weight. If we use this instead of the normal aggregates, then it is called as lightweight aggregate. The density of this lightweight aggregates ranges from 1750 kg per meter cube to 2000 kg per meter cube. Okay? It should not reach 2400 kg per meter cube. If it is reaching 2400, then it is called as normal cement concrete. one way. Whereas the lightweight aggregate, when you are using these kind of lightweight aggregates, the density should range from this. Even it can be less than 1,750 kilogram per meter. Okay, this is lightweight concrete. There are different methods of producing the lightweight concrete, which will be seen in detail when we go into the types of concrete. Next, we have the air engine concrete. So, in this air engine concrete, again the ingredients will be only cement, sand, water, then we have the air bubbles or the gas bubbles. Okay, and here also the most important thing is the sand will be finely crushed. It should be finely crushed. So when we see the normal fine aggregate, it will have some coarse materials also. So it has to be finely crushed, and you mix the cement and sand together, you induce air bubbles. Okay, you mix cement and sand together, finely crushed sand together, induce the air bubbles, and then you produce the aerated concrete, or it is also called as cellular concrete. It is also called as cellular concrete. So here the voids, that is the air bubbles, the size limitations are there. It should range from
0.1 to 1.
The range of the air bubbles and the air bubbles, the range size should be only 0.1 to 1 mm. It should not go beyond this. Or to go into China, it will not have the strength. Okay, so this is aerated or cellular concrete. Okay, this comes under lightweight. Okay, sawdust concrete. Here again, we will not have the coarse aggregate. Here the ingredients are cement, sawdust, water. So that is the sand component, which is sawdust replaced by sand. You can partially replace sand by sawdust, or you can fully replace sand by sawdust. So these are the ingredients for sawdust concrete. Mostly this will again have less weight. So what we are going to see here is, these are all the waste that are coming from certain industries. If we are using the waste material from industries, then it is called as industrial waste concrete. So majority of the sawdust from the furniture industry, all those are dumped as environmental hazards in the areas. So we are using it potentially in making concrete. So partially it can be used or fully it can be used based upon the area of application. The excess water which does not involve in the hydration process has to be removed. Okay, so to remove that excess water which is not involved in the hydration process, we will be using vacuum pump and vacuum mat. So mostly on the floor layers, a mat or sheet kind of thing will be placed. About the pump will be rolled electrically or powered by the electric power. So this pump pumps out the excess water and leaves it out from the concrete. So taking the excess water or removing the excess water from the concrete increases the strength and durability of the concrete. Okay, so this you can see mostly in rigid pavements, like flexible pavement, na road. Flexible pavement, bituminous roads, tar road. vacuum constantly plays a major role. Excess water has to be removed. Illana, it affects the strength and durability.